Still with us. Getting closer.
Well, then there's just one other chance. Full forward thrust. We've got to try to build up enough inertial drive to swing over it.
Full forward thrust.
Ready when you are. Whoa. Put on the brakes. Welcome, boys and girls, children of all ages, hoofties, puffties, bung-eyed heifers, right and left wing wackos, woodchucks and chuckettes, kings and queens of the Northeast Kingdom, and little dogs too, to another version of It's News to Us. Have you got anything to tell me this week? Yeah? Oh, thanks for the kisses. Lord knows where that tongue's been.
He's got a dog treat, did I know that?
Yeah. Got any dog secrets you want to tell me? Huh? Bar-ram you. Here's one for the governor. F you. Now, get out of there. You got your own camera. Go on. Oh, don't hide in the corner, you damn fool. He's so full of it. Anyways, welcome. You're watching It's News to Us. Whoa, hit that mic. It's hot as a $2 pistol. Thanks, Philo. In the booth, we have the College of Musical Knowledge, Philo T. Farnsworth, the inventor of modern American television. And he's greasing up his new ball joints.
Yes.
And you're watching It's News to Us. We're Newport's Orders TV News. 11 years so far. We had adult themes and adult language, but not really. And we do real news, no matter what the governor says. But where are the Bronze Age Invisible Sky Guide? Going to beat you and forgive you. You know, I was reading part of the old testicle today, speaking of Joe Bite Me.
He's almost that old.
Yeah, and I found the part where Solomon takes over as king. And he only asked the Lord for one thing, and that was the wisdom to know what is right from wrong. And Harry Truman actually used that very prayer when he became president in 1945. Yeah, and speaking of president, here's our senile geezer. Yeah, commander in chief. Yeah, I bet you're all happy now. Oh, we didn't like those Trump tweets, mister. He was terrible. Yeah, well, yeah, it's all over now, baby blue. And defund the police? No, we're going to defend the cops. The days of the good cops overlooking the bad cops are over, and they don't get paid nearly enough, and they have to deal with the same scum. And here we attack ideas, not people. Oh, and I got a new one, too. Check this out, Philo. You're going to love this. Because I'm still on the press list, I get a governor, stuff from the governor, right?
Yeah.
And from one of his little junior kiddies there in the administration, they said, like, hi, my name is Jordan, and my pronouns are he and him. It's like, you know what? And now it's not Happy Mother's Day, it's Happy Birthing Persons.
Hey, you know what, Steve? That Ben Shapiro just did a whole half-hour segment on that, and he was saying how when women don't want to be objectified, this does it right back at them. They're not even women. Now they're birthing persons.
Oh, it's, well, no, because they say men can be birthing persons too, Philo.
Oh, the hell with that.
And it's not breastfeeding anymore, it's chest feeding. It's like, you know what? When you see this stuff, when they try and foist this newspeak on you, just look right in their faces and laugh at them, okay? Just laugh at them. So my pronouns are and B-B-M. And my name is QLBX, but you can pronounce it Steve.
I saw that. Yeah, Ben Shapiro just did a whole thing on that.
They're insane, man.
They're beyond insane. They're going to turn us into some sort of a society that doesn't acknowledge anybody for anything.
Well, it's funny you mention that because, you know, over all these years, it's one thing that when you get old and gray, you have most of us get some sort of wisdom. He's hiding again. we get some sort of wisdom, and we find out that things either happen one of two ways. They either happen by plan or by accident, okay? And most always it's by plan, even when they say it's by accident, like Pearl Harbor being suddenly attacked by the Japanese, even though we had warning and people screaming from the radar shack and every other damn thing. And the same with 9/11. We still to this day don't know what fully happened on that day.
But and we always will.
Yeah, and something's going on here. And little blips of it came out. Remember a couple months ago, this guy came up to address the snowflakes up here. He was some climate greaser from Governor Charlie Parker's, that's what Biden calls him, Charlie Baker, but Biden calls him Governor Charlie Parker from Massachusetts. This guy,
you know. Isn't he a country singer or something?
Charlie Parker was a sax player.
Oh, that's right. Yeah, I got it.
Jazz, yeah. And so bite me. So anyways, this guy comes up from Massachusetts, and his name was Ismay. And the reason I remember that name is because that was the guy who designed and built the Titanic, Philo, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And there was another Ismay who was a general in the British Army during World War II. Anyways. So this Ismay guy came up and he said that we're going to have to put the screws to these people. They've been living large too long, okay? We're going to, they've got to pay more for energy so they use less, and they've got to stop driving, and they got to stop like using so much hot water, and and especially dryers. They got a real woody for dryers, because dryers, washers and dryers, dryers especially use a ton of energy. But hey, unless you got half a day to sit around and string up a line between your house and your garage and then put your laundry out there and air dry it. I mean, come on. Dryers are easy and convenient, and it's part of, being an American. But we're only 5% of the population here. We're using 25% of the energy. So he let the cat out of the bag, and lo and behold, when there was an uproar over it, he had to resign, Philo.
Hmm.
And speaking of friggin' giveaways, our auditor, God bless him, Doug Hoffer, the guy is good, okay? You know how much we've given our dairy industry, our declining dairy industry, basically the ones we're paying to pollute? For those of you who wonder what this thing is, it says gut pus right here. It says gut pus for a reason, because in every glass of milk, there is an SCC. It's called the somatic cell count, okay, which is the allowable levels of pus in your milk. Over the past 10 years, Doug Hopper's found, from 2010 to 2019, the state of Vermont has spent $285 million on the dairy industry, Philo.
Wow.
Yeah, yeah. And how many farms are there? It's under 2,000 now.
Yeah, I know of only a couple now.
Yeah, so basically we're paying to pollute. We're paying for them to pollute. And they're out there right now emptying the crap out of the damn manure pits and spreading it. I don't care about their buffer zones. The buffer zones are a joke. You get a good rain, the stuff runs right through those zones and into the friggin' creeks and rivers. But anyways, it gets even better. So I hope you're happy, okay? All you people that voted for Biden, and I'm sure there was a lot that didn't, because let's face it, the people in 2016, the people wanted Bernie Sanders. And who did they get? The most corrupt woman on the planet, Hillary Clinton. Okay.
Well, she isn't the most corrupt. She's right up there. She's probably neck and neck with a few others. But still hated by more.
Yeah, somebody called her blood-soaked the other night.
Well, she's hated by more people than any woman I know.
Yeah, she's a friggin' warmonger.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Well, he loves the military, except when it came to her or Billy serving. But none of her kids or her grandkids are going to serve and risk dying for this country.
Of course
not. You can
not bet
your ass on that one.
Neither did any of Bush's.
Yeah, exactly.
Or Cheney's people or anybody like that.
So again, we roll around 4 years later. We got Trump. Now, I don't care what you think about Trump or anything. We didn't like him in his tweets and whatever. I actually met the guy and talked to him. He's sure he's a braggart, he's a blowhard, but you know what? He had his own money and he wanted this country first. And it, you know, and they say, oh, you're America first, you're xenophobic. It's like, no, we're done being the world's police, okay? We're done giving away everything to the rest of the planet. It's time we looked out for our own people. We've got in the past, get this, in 1 month, they've apprehended 178,000 wetbacks down on the border. And they're coming in. No, they're not coming in for just from Mexico or Guatemala, Honduras, and El Salvador. They are coming in from Venezuela, from Cuba, from Africa, from places we don't even know. And these are the only ones they caught, 178,000. They say for every one we catch or turn themselves in, there are at least one or two that got away. That are bringing in drug. It's just nuts. Now, how many was there apprehended in the same month last year under Trump? 17,000. So we've gone from 17,000 to 178,000 in a month. Now, you multiply that over the past five months since Biden got elected, and look at what they're doing. These people have to be fed, housed, clothed, and they're shipping them all over the country free. They give them a piece of paper that says, you know, my name is Pedro, I don't speak English, but I'm going to Atlanta, Georgia. And they get free plane tickets and every other thing. Half of them ain't even tested for the friggin' virus. It's insane.
I don't see any of them wearing masks either.
Oh, no, it's funny that, don't you know?
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll give them those, too, when they come across.
Yeah, they don't have to wear masks, but I have to wear one to go into Costco.
Oh, yeah. And you have to be tested to do this or do that or get a vaccine and God knows what. Yet they come in scot-free. And meanwhile, how many U.S. citizens and veterans are homeless on the streets of the friggin' major cities in this country?
Too many to count.
Too many to count, exactly. Yet it's just nuts. And this is happening for a reason. All right. And, another thing, too. Speaking of the vaccines, I'm going to take my vaccine right here. See this? Let's see, camera two. Here's the needle right here. I got a good needle, yes. And it's all full of the green juice, right? And I'm going to take it, and I'm going to give myself a vaccine right now. Right in the jugular. Oh, does that feel good? Nothing. I'm on Team Pfizer now, said Joy Reid. Anyways, the vaccine adverse event reporting system, which they say only catches 1% of adverse effects because most people don't even bother notifying the CDC or the FDA of an adverse effect.
Or the KGB.
There have been 3,000 deaths. From this vaccine. They're not telling you that on the nightly news, are they?
Nope.
3,000 deaths, and 45% of these deaths happen on either day one, two, or three after getting the vaccine.
You know what I've noticed, Steve, on Facebook? You've got the people that are saying that there are no effects, and you've got the other. I've also noticed this. You've got some people that are saying that there are millions of people dying from this, and it's like, come on here. No.
Yeah.
It's kind of, come on, tell me the truth. I don't care.
Yeah, you have to hunt for the truth, but they do have the reported numbers. Like I said, it only amounts to 1%.
Well, so, I can tell you this, Steve. I had my second dose. I had my distemper shot Monday. I had the rabies shot a month ago. I had the distemper shot Monday. It's day three, and I haven't barked at the moon yet.
Yeah.
I can't even froth at the mouth.
Here's the difference between me and Philo, okay? Philo's good with this stuff. We both have different immune systems.
Yep, that's right.
And the thing is he's had flu shots and stuff like that, and he's never had any adverse effects. I had one flu shot in like 2014. And I'll tell you what, mister, to this day, I knew something was wrong right away. And to this day, I can't raise my right arm over my head and keep it up over there. And like an idiot, I didn't report it either, except to my doctor. And funny, too, because he says, oh, yeah, he says, I remember giving it to you in your left arm. Well, you know, I don't remember it that way, Doc, because, you know, this is why I remember it, Philo, right? Because I went in there, and he says, you want the right arm or the left arm? And I said, the right arm. He says, usually if you're right-handed, people want it in the left arm. I says, well, that may be true, Doc. I says, but, you know, when it comes to playing guitar, I make chords with my left hand. So even if I lost my finger-picking skills with my right hand, I could still use my right hand to strum or pick. But I need my left hand to work the fretboard. That's how I remember it. Somehow he remembers it differently. But anyways... and the CDC has lied to us again.
What's new?
Again, yeah, here's one right here for you. Virus told to drop sharply over the summer. You know, it's like they have been wrong on all their modeling, especially the IHME modeling, which comes out of, the University of Washington in Seattle, which is a fully bought and paid for organ of Bill Gates, a college dropout who makes crappy software and tells the rest of us what to do. President Joe Biden set a goal of delivering shots to 70% of adults by July 4th. Such a goal, if met, would fit in with the best case scenarios. Oh, you know what? Why does that idiot president still wear a mask?
Well, I don't want to catch his germs.
Especially outdoors. Yeah, really.
He's got germs.
He's outdoors. He's got the cooties. Outdoors. Him and Jill, the first geezer who thinks she's still a teenager, walking around in heels, you know, can barely stand up in the high heels. That woman, they have their masks on outdoors, and yet they go in to hang out with President Carter, who I guess Biden is all set to be just like President Carter. We're gonna get talked down to for the next 4 years. We're gonna be told that we use too much energy. We're gonna have gas lines again at the pumps, fist fights at the pumps. You'll see. You watch what happens. They don't get this pipeline up and running. It's gonna be just like 1979 all over again.
Like 1973 also.
Yeah, yeah,
I remember the first one.
Somehow that didn't seem as bad.
That one was the one where gas went from 30 cents way up to about a buck.
Oh, yeah.
That one, I remember that more than in 79, but anyways, both of them were bad.
And look at Katrina. I mean, there was plenty of gas. The refineries were knocked out for a while, but it was my mom died right about the same time as I was moving stuff back and forth from the flatlands up here. And the gas was $4 a gallon in 2008.
Yeah, $4.67 here up at Cumberland Farms. And guess who was the president?
Bush.
Yes, he was.
Mr. Gas Man.
Yeah. Gas bag.
Yeah. Oh, man. Under more pessimistic scenarios, with subpar vaccination and declining use of masks and social distancing, weekly caseloads would still drop, but could number in the hundreds of thousands, with tens of thousands of hospitalizations and thousands of deaths, lions and tigers and bears, oh my.
Well, you know, here's the thing. When they keep reporting the number of deaths, they keep saying the number of deaths from COVID.
It's not true.
It's the number that have died with it.
Exactly.
And a whole bunch of people, over half.
And they get paid more.
Half of them, they've got some other symptom, like Don Wells had stage 4 cancer.
16%. They estimate 16%. So if they're saying that 500,000 people have died, 16% of them have died from COVID only.
And most of them are probably in nursing homes.
Exactly. And they're not old. They're not young people either.
No.
Now, we just find out that the CDC said that there was a 10% risk of spreading the virus outdoors, okay? Now, they used a Singapore study, one study they used to come up with this policy, right? And the Singapore study was with construction workers who happened to work outside, Philo, but guess where they all gathered at lunchtime?
Probably McDonald's, no?
All together in some friggin' trailer or construction shack.
Huh.
It turns out that 0.1%, this is from the New York Times, okay? This is not coming from some right-wing news organization. This is the New York Times. They reported that 0.1%, and there's not a single documented case of outdoor transmission. So the CDC was off by a factor of 100 times.
Well, that's pretty close for them, you know. I could tell you some other things. They were telling women back in the 50s and 60s, don't breastfeed. Formula is much better.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And in the 50s, they were saying cigarettes were not harmful.
9 out of 10 doctors prefer camels.
The camel toe, I don't know which.
Yeah. And they never mention, the treatments, too, where they've been using ivermectin, dextromethazone, which is a steroid, monoclonal antibodies, and even, yes, hydroxychloroquine, the one they made fun of Trump for all those months. Trump has double kill you. Oh, even though it's been on the market since 1958. Oh, geez. And, okay. Now, you want to talk about inflation? This American Rescue Plan, or as President Geiser says, the American Rescue Pan, they're printing up so much money that this is what happens, okay? The price of lumber has risen, okay, in the past 6 months. The price of lumber has risen by 280%, Philo.
Oh, yeah. Oh, I know.
They're talking about the what it'll cost to the addition of this price to the cost of building a house. It will add approximately $20,000 to $35,000 to the price of a house with lumber and plywood. All right, the price of gasoline has doubled. Right now, as I speak, 1/5 of all gas stations in the Atlanta area are closed, and 43%, this is another thing too. The polls, the Joe Bite Me polls that say what a great job he's doing, our fearless leader, you know, like if we live in North Korea now. The polls are oversampled. They use they oversample Democrats by 20% or more. Now, meanwhile, the East Coast gas, 43% of all East Coast gas uses this pipeline, and it was shut down by foreign hackers. That's what they're saying. Even though any hacker anywhere, we know this from the CIA, can spoof or mirror the server where they're coming from to make it look like they're in Tokyo or Venezuela or Moscow, any place that's served by fiber optics or satellite, whatever. They can spoof where they're from, but they're saying, oh, it's the Russians. But what is our DHS doing, Philo? Where are they looking for the enemy?
Oh, Russia, obviously.
Well, that's what they're saying on the news. But our DHS is now after domestic extremists, i.e. people who don't vote the right way, evidently. Domestic extremists.
Oh, that's a bad bunch.
Yeah, yeah. Well, you know what Barry Goldwater said about extremism, right? Because I'm thinking, where have I heard this extremism stuff before? Where have I heard it before? And then it brought me back to 1964 when I was a Goldwater kid, where they called Barry Goldwater an extremist. And they said, well, if you vote for that Goldwater guy, he's going to get us into a nuclear war. Yeah, well, but never mind. We voted for Johnson, and he got us into the Vietnam War. Anyways, Barry Goldwater, when they called him extremist, he said, you know what he said? He said, yeah, you're damn right I'm an extremist, because we're losing our liberties, okay? And extremism in defense of liberty is no vice, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the same now. And when I hear the President of the United States, it is addressed to a half-assed, socially distanced bunch of idiots spread out all over the chamber saying that no rights are absolute. I mean, that is like, holy moly, wait a minute, the Bill of Rights are absolute. But anyways.
You wouldn't believe the ad that Johnson wanted to play on Goldwater, but his people told him not to.
Oh, the Daisy ad.
Well, it was the one where the Vietnamese children are staying there and an atomic bomb goes off.
Well, yeah, they and the Daisy one, that one never aired, really. I mean, it came out. And they showed it. It's still on YouTube. You can see it where this girl's saying, she loves me, loves me not, pulling off petals off a daisy. And in the background, you can hear it going, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And then you see a mushroom cloud. It's like, man.
Yeah. Johnson's people made that. You wouldn't believe what Goldwater's people came up with that didn't air either. Johnson driving down the highway throwing beer cans out of his car.
I sent you that link to YouTube. That's great. Yeah, it shows this drunk-ass somebody driving a Lincoln Continental, weaving all over the road, beer cans flying out of it. Oh, man.
That might actually have been fun.
And speaking of which, mark your calendar, because this Saturday, Governor Scott's going to reinstate the state of emergency.
He is?
Oh, sure. Yep. Yep. Gotta keep this hoax going, Philo.
Yep. And you know, I'm running into more and more and more people who are fed up with it, but they don't seem to be saying anything.
You think?
They don't say anything.
Yeah. Well, because they're worried about being attacked by snowflakes.
Well, you know what? Snowflakes melt.
Yeah.
Right?
Meanwhile, in the free states, and here's a problem, too. This is the first time we've had a high unemployment level, and yet employers can't find employees.
That's right. They can't.
Because people are making too much money with the PUA, the PUA, the Pandemic Unemployment Assistance.
Well, that's supposed to end May 1st, wasn't it?
Yeah, in some states, yeah. And which adds, what, $300 a week?
Yep.
Iowa, which has been open, their schools have been open since August. Iowa Governor Kim Reynolds, they got a 3% unemployment rate, and Kim Reynolds has stopped the PUA, and she's not having it. And you know, and that's just the way it is.
Well, my wife is going out to Montana to see one of our granddaughters graduate high school. And Nobody wears a mask.
No.
There are no forced vaccinations. If you want to get it, you get it. If
yeah.
you don't want to, you don't have to.
My body, my choice.
Yeah, and that's what you and I have been about all along. If I choose to get it, that's my business, and I shouldn't be coerced one way or the other, the same as you.
Yeah, and
simple.
And hell, if I were symptomatic, if I didn't feel good, was running a temperature or whatever, which I never do, knock on wood, I wouldn't come in here. I would stay home. That's the best thing, best advice anyone can give you. Oh, man.
Don't get us started on this one.
And what happened to the flu, Philo? What happened to the flu?
There were no cases this year.
Yeah.
None.
Over the past decade, symptomatic systems of the flu have sent between 9 and 45 million people a year to the hospital. All right? I mean, there were 9 to 45 million people with symptoms of flu symptoms. It routinely sent between 140 to 810,000 people to the hospital a year, and it killed between 12 and 61,000 people a year, the flu did. Now, there's no more flu. They estimate that there are 200 deaths from flu. And the flu, it killed kids at a rate of between 144 to 198 a year for 3 years. Now they're saying we lost one kid to the flu. What in the hell is going on? How long do they have to lie to us before we figure out that we're getting taken for a ride, man?
Well, one thing that I do find interesting is that doctors don't get any extra money for diagnosing COVID, but hospitals do.
Oh, yeah.
The doctors aren't making any money on this.
Nope, and the hospitals are, and so are funeral homes now, too, because FEMA is going to start paying up to, what is it, $35,000 or something for funerals? It's just nuts. Okay, just keep printing that money. There'll be no adverse effects. So you just print up all the money you want.
Well, one good thing's come out of this. They let me have my last hip operation over at Gifford Memorial. That was a godsend. It was great.
Yeah. Oh, get this. Here we are. Review of EEOC district office ordered. They got another Black Lives Matter person bitching and moaning.
Oh, whoa, 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 whoa.
Yeah. The head of a federal right civil agency ordered a review of the Dallas office after widespread complaints of internal discrimination. Left employees further disillusioned. Oh, God almighty. I got other stuff to get to. Here's one. Biden using state data to sell his family plan. No, pan, whatever he calls it. Oh, and we got in here, too.
Pots and pans.
Yeah. Biden pushes for diversity and transition to clean energy. Yeah, you know what the transition to clean energy is? It's going to cost you twice as much to heat your house, and you're not going to be able to get any gas for your car. Some parents see racism escape in remote learning. Well, some people see racism everywhere. What was the latest thing that's racist now? Oh, the Dewey Decimal System. Did you hear that one? The Dewey Decimal System is now racist.
Please, why is that racist?
Oh, I don't know, because it's named after a white guy or some damn thing.
Oh, well, that'll do it, I guess. Besides, I'm not white, I'm Italian.
Yeah. It's actually a book called When the Italians Became White. I go figure.
That took a while, I guess.
Like I said, we had two Italian families in my hometown that were blonde hair, blue eyes, and yet I had my good buddy Gary, who lost his son down here in Plainfield years ago. If he's out in the sun roofing, he'd qualify for being black. Oh, we're supposed to trust Kismikia.
Who's that?
Oh, Kismikia. She's a scientist. Yeah. This is from today's paper. Poll, most in U.S. who remain unvaccinated need convincing. That's where the NIH immunologist Kismikia Corbett comes in. Let's see. She helped lead development of the Moderna shot, which if you go to the Moderna patent application, go scroll down to number 26, read paragraph 40. It shows that they use AIDS parts to get into your cells. She spends hours giving plain-spoken answers to questions from Americans, especially black Americans like her, to counter misinformation about the three vaccines. No, COVID vaccines won't cause infertility. Whoever started that rumor, shame on you. Well, it's not. We don't know about infertility. As usual, we don't know because it hasn't been tested long enough. And women have been saying that it screws up their periods right off the bat. I mean, within weeks, so something's happening.
I'm very worried about infertility at my age.
Me too.
And the fact that I had a vasectomy when I was 29.
Get this. There's a notice in here about Ponzi Peak, Philo.
Oh, what is it?
It's a public notice. Get this. United States District Court, Southern District of Florida, case number 16, CV21301-Gales. SEC plaintiff versus Ariel Quiro, William Stinger, J. Peak Inc. or Resorts Inc., J. Peak Hotel Suites, J. Peak Hotel Suites Phase 2, J. Peak Management, J. Peak Penthouse, J. Peak GP Services, J. Peak Golf and Mountain Suites, J. Peak GP Services Golf Inc., J. Peak Lodge and Townhouses, J. Peak GP Service Lodge, J. Peak Hotel Suite Stateside, J. Peak GP Services Stateside, J. Peak Biomedical Research Park, LP, NC Bio, my favorite. Goodbye, Joe, me gotta go, NC Bio. That one had the mayor fooled. Oh, the mayor said it's all coming. You guys are just naysayers, mister. Oh, Mr. Mayor, how's it working out now? NC Bio Vermont GP Services, LLC, defendants. J Construction Management, Inc., GSI of Dade County. Northeast Contract Services, Inc., Q Burke Mountain Resort. Relief defendants and Q Burke Mountain Resort Hotel and Conference Center. Q Burke Mountain Resort GP Services, LLC, additional defendants. Notices of proceedings to approve settlement among receiver, putative class plaintiffs, and People's United Bank, N.A., and bar order. I need a martini after that one, Philo. Speaking of bar orders.
I'll drink to that.
Oh, man. Please take further notice. the copies of the settlement agreement, the motion for approval, blah, 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 approval of form, purpose of bar order, may be obtained from the court's docket and the SEC action from the website created by the receiver, www.jpreceivership.com. Copies of the motion may also be obtained by email to Kimberly Smiley at kimberlysmiley@ackerman.com or by phone by calling her at 954-759-8929. Please take further notice that the final hearing on the motion, at which time the court will consider approval of settlement agreement. Okay. I told you it was going to bring jobs to the Northeast Kingdom, right, Philo?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
They got my poor wife all jazzed up. She was all ready for this and everything. I said, you just wait and see. When it happens, I'll believe it.
And week after week after week, man. Voting changes put heat on county officials. Well, you know what? It's Article 1, Section 2, something like that. It specifically states in the Constitution that elections, time and date of the elections and places, blah, 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 are set by the states. They're set by the states for a reason. Oh, man, here we are. Oh, but anyways, Biden pushes for diversity and transition to clean energy. You're going to love this one. The Department of Energy announced $15.5 million in new funding to deploy solar energy in underserved communities and to build a more diverse, skilled workforce to help reach the administration's ambitious goal of 100% clean energy by 2035. Yeah, ask Texas how that worked out during the ice storm. And the windmills down here. Our grid is so crappy, the windmills are shut off half the time because they can't take the load. I mean, they shut down the windmills in Lowell because they can't take the load either. Oh, thanks, Todster.
I was going to give that to you earlier.
Oh, yeah, this is another one, too. The news you won't hear.
Hot off the press.
Thanks. Hot off the presses. From our NEK-TV news division. This is from the United States Attorney's Office, District of Massachusetts. 19 Brazilian nationals charged in nationwide conspiracy to open fraudulent driver accounts and leading rideshare and delivery service companies. No, see, you know what they're doing, Philo? They're only stealing the money that the American citizens can't be bothered to steal, right?
I guess so.
Scheme involved use of more than 2,000 stolen identities. They are charged today with a nationwide conspiracy to set up fraudulent driver accounts, to rideshare delivery service, blah, blah, blah. The scheme also involved using fraudulent accounts to exploit referral bonus programs and using bots and GPS spoofing to increase the income earned from these accounts. They estimate more than 2,000 identities are stolen. The scheme alleged in today's charge are extensive, violating customers' privacy and enabled unqualified drivers to work for rideshare and food delivery services. Because, see, when you start handing out tons of pickup loads of friggin' government cheese, don't be surprised if you get a lot of rats coming in to pick up the cheese. You know what I mean? 19 of them. How about some names, Philo? Wemerson Dutra Aguiar, 25, Brazilian, living in Lynn in Woburn, Mass. Priscila Barbosa, Saugus, Mass. Edvaldo Rocha Cabral, Lowell, Mass. Clovis Cardecas Placido, Citrus Heights, California. Guilherme de Silveira, 28, Revere, Mass. Flavio Candido da Silva, Revere, Mass. Alcacir Diaz Guimeras Nito. How do you fit that in the box, man? In Kissimmee, Florida. Kissimmee once, Kissimmee twice, Kissimmee once again. Bruno Provencio Abreu, 28, Saugus. Jordano Augusto Lima Guimarães, 34, Salem, Mass. Alessandro Felix de Fonseca, 25, Revere, Mass. 9 defendants remain at large. Huh. You think they're headed back on a slow boat to Sao Paulo?
To Ireland.
Yeah. Anyways, back to the diversity. Here we go with the diversity again.
Oh, I just love that stuff.
Another $17 million announced Monday for internships and research opportunities designed to connect students and faculty in science, technology, and math, engineering and math, with resources at the DOE's laboratories. Biden has set a goal of 40% of overall benefits of federal climate and clean energy investment goes to disadvantaged communities. Now, mind you, you take a community like Baltimore, where it's like, 80, 90% black? They are the fourth highest per capita cost per student in all the country, okay? They're number four when it comes to teachers' salaries and everything else. Yet, what's their scores for reading, math, and stuff like that? The dropouts, they got like a 50% dropout rate. The kids can't read, they can't write. But, boy, we're going to start teaching them the 1619 Project and that Whitey's bad, and, you know, and Joe Biden's going to give them money, too. The administration is really committed. Get that. This sounds like North Korean. Honest to God, it sounds like a North Korean thing. This administration is really committed to making the transition to clean energy an inclusive transition, offering benefits to every community, because not every community has benefited up to this point, said Energy Senate Secretary Jennifer Granholm, the former corrupt governor of Michigan. In a discussion at Howard University, a historically black college. In fact, some communities, particularly communities that are indigent and black and people of color, have disproportionately been negatively affected by pollution. So we want to make sure that the voices are at the table. Yeah, voices are at the table. No, it's snouts at the trough. That's what we want. We want to get our snouts at the trough while we listen to their voices at the table.
Voice inside my head.
Yeah. Good grief, man. The problem stems from inequities in research infrastructure, such as grants and personnel to administer them, as well as access to top laboratories. For example, not having state-of-the-art research laboratories could prevent or minimize faculty members from getting or obtaining preliminary data to demonstrate a proof of concept that's needed to complete these research funds. Many faculty members also have a heavy teaching workload, and there may be implicit bias during the review process.
Oh, no. Implicit.
Implicit bias. That's when you don't even know you have it. That's how bad it is.
I'd rather see something explicit.
Expletive deleted. Oh, man. Explicit bias. Data shows that the U.S. Data shows that the U.S. needs diversity in science, technology, engineering, and math, and it's a huge priority for the Bite Me administration. Yeah, we need science, technology, engineering, and math, but how's it going to work when you got teachers' unions that have been sitting on their ass for the past year in some states, the lockdown states? Even though kids don't get sick from this damn virus, and how are we going to? And even when they do show up, the students' track records and score results are so poor that it's like they can't even read at a fourth grade level. You got to be kidding me.
The Energy Department under Bite Me has awarded research grants to students and faculty from 57 institutions, nearly half of which were minority-serving institutions.
They're serving minorities? What are they serving them? Are they serving them the same BS they're serving us, Philo?
I want to be served a couple of burgers and a soda, you know?
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, serving. All right. And get this. This is my favorite. The solar funding, announced Tuesday, will provide free technical assistance to communities to streamline the process for installing solar. So how do you streamline the process? What does that mean? Instead of having licensed electricians, we're just going to allow anybody to do it?
It would be nice if they cut out some of the bureaucracy, but that's another story altogether.
Yeah, don't mind it if the switch is wrong and the grid goes down and some poor lineman's out on a pole trying to fix the grid. And somebody's solar panels accidentally kick on, died to a friggin' piece of bacon.
Yep.
Well, you know, he wasn't a licensed electrician, but he was part of an underserved group. You know, he got that grant money, and we needed to have X amount of people of color.
streamline the process for installing solar. That, in turn, helps attract investment and lowers energy costs for consumers. Oh, sure. All hail our fearless leader, Kim Jong-Biden. I've never seen anything like this, dude. I have never, ever seen anything like this in my life. Well, here we are. Oh, did you see that clip of Rand Paul going after St. Tony Fauci yesterday?
Yes, you sent me that link and I watched it.
It's insane. Fauci, I mean, that the guy who did the research, this gain-of-function weaponization research where they weaponized this virus, he even put in the footnotes like a thank you to the NIH for giving him the grant, stuff like that. And it all leads back to Fauci, and Fauci saying, well, no, I didn't do that. But yet he allowed the loophole so that his panel could use our tax dollars for them to play with these viruses, and now the truth is finally coming out. And he's all like, well, Fauci's here, I didn't do it. No, you're wrong, Senator. I didn't do it. And here we are. This is a good one. Scientists on stopping the next virus. Oh, really? That's easy. Just don't create them, you fools. That Wuhan laboratory, they had complaints from the embassy going back to 18 or something. In that damn laboratory, Philo, it was like a level 2. It was supposed to be level 3, but it was so bad it was like level 2. And you know what level 2 is roughly like? A level 2 laboratory takes roughly the same precautions as people in your dental offices. It's insane. And here we are.
You should see the ones in my mental office.
Yeah, the mental floss. That's what everybody needs right now because we're getting fed a bunch of crap. Facebook panel ruling upholds Trump ban. Ah, I see. So Zuckerberg and Facebook say 9. Oh, okay.
Maybe even 10.
Yeah. 9, Herr Führer. 9. Okay. See, the guys that runs Hamas and the Ayatollah, they have Facebook pages, and Louis Farrakhan and racists and ne'er-do-wells of all stripes. But the former president, we're going to make sure he never gets back on there. And you know what? He's not going to have to, because if he wants to run again, chances are he's going to win, because these guys are going to take this country, throw it in the crapper, and people are going to look back and say, which did you hate more about Trump, the peace or the prosperity? Oh, man. Trust Kizmikia. Kizmikia. Here we are. Biden approval buoyed by COVID-19 response. I mean, come on. Really? COVID-19 response? It was all warp speed. I know warp speed is a stupid name for something, but you know, it was all put in place by Trump. You think that they didn't start handing out the vaccines until a week after the election? I'm sure that's all completely coincidental.
And California got theirs way before Vermont.
Yeah, funny that. And here we are. Data shows accelerated rise in anti-Asian attacks. Well, you know, here's the thing about these anti-Asian attacks, boys and girls. If you look at the surveillance video, because cameras are cheap and everywhere now, right? It's not like Trump supporters and white Klan members coming into the city and attacking Asians, boys and girls. It's black people that are attacking the Asians. Who are you going to believe, us or your lion eyes?
Would we then assume it was the Asian people that brought the slaves over here?
Oh, man. No, that's another thing. The 1619 Project, dude, that was a pirate ship that showed up, right? And they wanted to be outfitted. They'd already sold a bunch of slaves, and they captured a Portuguese slave ship, right? And they sold a bunch of slaves in either the Bermuda or the Bahamas or the West Indies, right? So then they came up to Jamestown, and they didn't actually sell them. Well, they sold them, but they were indentured servants because, you know, slavery, it was like outlawed, or
not outlawed, but it was frowned upon, where indentured servitude wasn't. There's a book about that. I got to get it.
Yeah, but it's okay because the Bible says so.
Yeah, exactly. Well, this, I got to show this to Todd. That Nancy Wilson, she gave Eddie Van Halen his first acoustic guitar. He had never had an acoustic guitar before. She says she learned the famed musician never played acoustic guitar, so she gifted him one. She didn't give him one. She gifted him one, Philo.
Oh, yeah.
Must have been part of a conversation, right?
Speaking of which.
Yeah. Monday, May 10th, was the anniversary of Ethan Allen taking Fort Ticonderoga with Benedict Arnold. You know what he said? They said, well, you got come out in the name of the great Jehovah or whatever. Actually, what he said was, come on out of there, you dirty old rat. Oh, so we're a nation of pussies now. Yep.
Remember, I told somebody this on Facebook. I said, with all the snowflakes, cupcakes, and Twinkies, they now make the wimp quirks and pencil neck geeks look manly.
Yeah, sure do. And this is from today's paper. Divorce during the pandemic. Oops, sorry.
Crash.
They're going to keep pushing this pandemic, Philo. It is never going to end in the state of Vermont.
No.
And here we are. McConnell leads charge, McTurtle, against voting rights bill. Well, you know what? Article 1, Section 4 specifically gives to the states the right to do election law. And they did that for a reason, so that Congress couldn't control the people who were running elections. And this is written like it was from North Korea. Republicans scores of amendments to highlight aspects that they believe are unpopular, including the creation of public financing systems for political campaigns. Oh, that's just what I want to do. I wanted to have our tax dollars given to, like, Patrick Leahy so he can run again, Philo. Public financing of elections? No, I don't think so.
I'm rather fed up with the fact that the president has a term limit and nobody else does.
Yeah, how's that work?
This is why you have career politicians that constantly make more money. They should have term limits just like the president.
Exactly. Well, here we are. The congressional effort comes as states including Georgia, Florida, Arizona, and Texas. Oh, yeah, and they're doing the recount in Arizona, and now the Department of Justice wants to step in. It's like, wait a minute, no, get your ass out of there. These people have raised the money, and they're paying for it, and we're going to see if there was something hinky going on. And if you claim that the election was free and fair, why not let them proceed, Philo?
Yep, that's right.
What do you got to hide? We know exactly what they got to hide, because every swinging Dick and Harry came in, and Zuckerberg spent over $500 million to hand out Zuckerbucks. It was insane in all these states. An overhaul of the federal agency that polices elections and dozens of provisions that dictates how states conduct their elections. Go back to the Constitution. Let's see. Democrats are on defense, having been unable to halt the onslaught of new state rules that'll take months or years to litigate in court. Passage of legislating options to counteract the GOP efforts. These bills are moving in state capitals across America are not empty threats. They are real efforts to stop people from voting, said Senator Amy Klobuchar, who like Kamala Harris, couldn't get anyone to vote for her in Iowa because she's such an empty suit. It's not designed to stop anyone. And stop treating black people like they were kids. Oh, they're like little children. They don't have any photo ID. They never rent cars. They never buy beer or wine. They never buy cigarettes. Oh, speaking of which, the government wants to outlaw menthol cigarettes to help black people, Philo.
Yeah, right. That's going to... Yeah, only black people smoke menthol?
Yeah. I got a pack of Newports last week. I was out of pre-rolls. It's insane. They already banned them in Massachusetts. Did you know that?
Didn't know that.
Yeah. Sales of menthol cigarettes are banned in Massachusetts. So the tide going across the border to get them in New Hampshire, Rhode Island, and Connecticut is friggin' unbelievable.
Yeah, Republicans argue the new state rules are needed to clamp down on mail ballots and other methods that became popular during the pandemic.
Well, yeah, they became popular because they were illegal. Some swinging Dick and Jane comes into a state, it brings a lawsuit against the Secretary of State and says, we got to have drop boxes and all this other stuff and ballot harvesting and just sending out ballots to, you know, to everybody, whether they're on the rolls, alive, dead. They many states didn't even check the voting rolls against the Social Security death rolls. I mean, that's how you tell if people are alive or dead, if they stop getting a check, man. Social Security is pretty good about that. If you die, you don't get checks anymore. So it only goes to figure that if you're not getting a check anymore and you're dead, you shouldn't be voting. But what am I to know them? You know, we're just going to hurt black people and Hispanics and Asians, too. You know, they're like little children. We got to look out for them. You got to be kidding me. What does that say to, what are you saying to minorities with that?
Well, you know, this is the thing. The liberals want to keep this issue alive. And the more they treat them this way, the more they fall into this victimization category.
The more they're going to drive them into conservative camps, I think.
I might hope so.
You know, honest to God, when we started the show 11 years ago, I'm still listed as Comrade Steve on YouTube. Me and Philo were as left could be. We didn't believe in Bush or any of that crap. And then we saw, when I saw what happened with Obama, he was the biggest disappointment. And that started with that friggin' oil leak in the Gulf of Mexico, where he sat on his hands and watched the friggin' oil come out and kill the Gulf of Mexico. He could have sent in the Navy's deep water people to cap it, but he didn't. And it just went on and on. And anyways, so now we're still the same people. We still have the same ideas and beliefs. Yet this party has somehow just gone and done a complete 180. It's like, what happened to my Democratic Party?
Neoliberal fascists took over.
I guess
by the way,
so.
Last but not least.
All right. Last but not least. I didn't find the damn thing. The CDC has lied to thee over and over again. Proper LGBT12C3PO bill in Senate. You know why? Because, look, even transvestites or whatever they're calling them, transmissions. Transgesters, yes.
Transgenders, sorry.
Transgesters. Even the transgesters are saying no bio men in women's sports. That's
Caitlyn Jenner even said that.
Yeah.
In her run for California.
Yeah, and the lesbians, and that's the thing. You got men and you got women, and you got men's and women's sports, and never the twain shall meet, I'm sorry, because the men will beat women 9 times out of 10. Well, once again, you wasted a perfectly good hour. Come on, hour of your life watching this stupid show. So hopefully we'll see you again next week, inshallah. Until then, get down on your hands and knees in the men-only mosque, sniff the bum of the guy in the man dressed next to you, head east and pray towards the meteorite Mecca and say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Mecca. Stinky old dog.
And a Deus Magnus S to everyone.
Good boy.